everybody. Welcome back to the channel. If you saw last week's video, you'll see that we worked on this John Deere. Got it running. Honestly, didn't have to do anything to it. It was already a running and driving machine. We fixed the steering gear on it. And then I still kind of felt a little bit of tension in it. Nothing as bad as it was. And I mean, I ended up cutting my yard with it and we didn't have any issues. But some of the things that we kind of had known, the tire itself on this side, the tire shot. I did end up ordering a new one, so we have that. We'll get that put on today. Another thing that I ended up noticing, I thought that the wheel bearings were shot on this. The wheel bearings are not shot, and we'll see here in a little bit that it wasn't the wheel bearings that were causing as bad of an issue on this side as what it is. I did forget to order new wheel bearings, so we don't have new wheel bearings, but we are going to replace the spindles. We might replace both sides, I'm not sure. I have both of them, but this side we're definitely going to have to replace. Other than that, I did get new blades for it as well, since the ones that we had were not the correct ones. So I have the correct blades now. I don't know if we will pull the deck off right now and change those out. But we're definitely going to look into the front end and hopefully get that all figured out, as well as I have stuff to do a tune-up on this. So what I'm going to do now is I want to go and get air put in these tires quick, so that way we can get it pulled into the garage, and we'll get this front end up in the air. So I don't know how well it's going to really pick it up on camera here, but if you can see in where the hub is. So if you can see in here where the hub is at, there's a good gapping in between that, which is why I was thinking the bearings were shot or missing. And if you can hear the hissing going on, that's our tire. That tire is completely shot. So that's why we're gonna replace the tire. So I'm gonna set the camera up here and we'll get this up in the air a little bit and get this tire off, and I'll show you what's going on with the spindle there. So, as you can see right off the bat, she's all over the place. So, let's get that clip off of there. Might just be able to use these. Maybe not, might not be enough to get in there. There we go. Set that off to the side. Take our washer off. And we can just pull that straight off. And I'm gonna show you guys here. So, top of our shaft, no big deal. It's like it's supposed to be. Then you look, we'll see if it'll focus there. That bottom is completely worn out. That's not supposed to be worn down like that. So, yeah, our spindle needs to be replaced. That's all there is to that. Like I said, I do have a new one. Guys, I mean, this doesn't look like it's been taken care of at all either. So we'll definitely get everything greased up. So let me see what we're going to need to take all this off, and I'll bring it with me when I go take it off and put the new one on. First thing that we're going to do to take this off, we're going to take our tie rod off, which should just be a 11/16 on the bottom and a half inch to hold the top nut. And it helps if you go the right way with it. You got your tie rod off of there. We can just kind of set that off to the side for now. And then at the top of your spindle, you've got a bushing cap that goes on top, or dust cap. And then we just have another snap ring up here. See if we can get this without losing it. Okay, so we got that off. Put that in our cap, and then we have a washer there. Gonna set that off to the side. And now we should be free to just take this right off of here. I don't really know what else would be holding it. Let's see. I'm just gonna take a small hammer and tap. Wow, that is really on there. I think that has a lot to do with our steering issue. Well, it's starting to come. All right, I'm going to keep working on this to see if we can get this out of here. Thank you.
Well, finally got it out. I don't know if you guys can see how bad that shaft is, but I'd say she was pretty well seized in there. After quite a bit of fighting this with a bee cursing, a grinder, we finally got it out of there. See if you guys can kind of see our shaft where the wheel sits now. That's pretty well shot on the front and back for where the bearing is. So I do kind of wish I had some bearings right now. That way we could replace those as well. But we are going to replace the spindles. I think we're going to replace the other side as well. And especially since this side was as bad as it was, I'm hoping the other side's not the same way. But I guess we're going to find that out. I did unfortunately sacrifice our grease zerk right there. So I will have to try to extract that and put a new one in there. I don't have any grease zerks right now, so I'm not going to be able to do that tonight. We are going to throw a shit ton of grease down the spindle, down the shaft though, as well as put some grease on the new spindle before we put it in there. So we do have our new one here. These are right and left specific, just that way you know that. I'm gonna, before I do anything, I do want to make sure, hopefully this is gonna be the correct size. It should be, because that's what it was. I just feel like it's gonna fight us a little bit though. So hopefully we can just kind of throw some grease on her and send her away. So let me get some grease here quick and then we'll put these on. Throw some grease into the shaft. Help lubricate that up a little bit. Hopefully it'll make it a little bit easier. At least we can only hope. So I am gonna get a little bit on my hand here. And we will just put that onto our new spindle. We don't want it all dry, otherwise we're going to run into the same issue that we just had with the old one. As I'm really hoping that these aftermarket ones aren't going to be a bigger size than what we have here, because I don't have any way of reaming this out more. All right, I'm going to fight with this a little bit, and I'll bring you back. All right, so we're going to try this again. I think that the paint that they put on from the company that did these. I just think that the paint itself was making the bore too big on, or I think it was making the shaft too big for the bore itself, because I went through, I cleaned up the shaft pretty well, and it still didn't want to go through. So what I ended up just doing is I just went through, I just ground down all the paint off of the part that goes into there. So let's just grease this up quick. I got some grease on there. Let's see if we can get this to slide through here now. Oh, that was a lot better. Oh yeah, and that spins much more freely than it was before. That's what we want to see. So now we have that back on there. Now we can go back to installing our pins and our retainer clips. So let's see, what do I got here? Got this one that goes on the top. Clean that off quick. Throw that washer on there, and then we have wherever that retaining clip went. Oh, that's right, I put it inside the boot. So now we can put our retainer clip on there. Stubborn. I'm grabbing the washer too. Shoot. These clips are not the most fun to put on. I don't know where our clip just went. Okay, so I did end up finding that clip. Guys, that's moving so much better than before. So maybe the other side's going to be the same way, and hopefully that fixes our steering issues with how tight everything was. So next thing that we're going to do, we'll take our tie rod again, and we'll put our tie rod back on there. Get that tightened back up. I do think that this had a lot to do with why our steering gear stripped out. Again, I mean, it was stripped out already before we got it. But also the guy that I bought it off of didn't really care too much about the machine. He used it just to cut grass up at his cabin, and basically he beat the hell out of it. He was straight up with me about that. Didn't really do much with the machine. So it's to be expected when you don't take care of your equipment. So I am going to go take the tire out from underneath the other side quick and see if that spins better now. Let's see if our steering wheel actually... Oh, that's a lot better. Honestly, our other side... I don't know if our other side is going to be bad or not. We might just change it out just because we have two new ones. Guys, I mean, it might just need to be greased up because we saw how dry this side was. So I think what we're going to do for now is we're just going to concentrate on this side. We'll grease the other side up. But I think next, let me actually grab our tire quick. Just see how it does on our new shaft before I go and put the new tire on our rim. Slide that on there. And, well, I mean, guys, there's still play there. So I do think our wheel bearings are shot. I did not look at the other side, honestly. We do have play in the other side as well. Not as bad as this side, but we do have some play. So I think I will get some new bearings for these. But for now, since I don't have them tonight, let's at least go and get our new tire thrown on here on the new rim. So I'll show you that here. So the first thing you want to do, you want to pop your tire off of the bead. Sometimes they'll go easy and you can just kind of step on them and break the bead off that way. Like that went off nice. Flip it over, we'll do the other side. Side's gonna be a little more stubborn, it looks like. There we go. So now that our bead is popped on there, let me grab some
grab some pry bars. Gonna take our pry bar. Gonna try and work our pry bars around. Just want to work it a little bit at a time. Does work better with tire spoons, but we don't have those right now, so that's why we're just gonna use pry bars. They work as well, just takes a little bit more work. Enough, almost hung up on the valve stem. There we go. And we got the front off. Sometimes it can go . Sometimes some of them kind of fall off easy. I've had some of them fall off pretty easy that way. This one's apparently not going to. So we'll do the same thing. There we go. So I was able to just push it off from the backside. Now, rim looks okay. It doesn't look damaged. So now we can take our new tire. So I have our new tire here. Looks like it's the same one as our other one. Let's go. We'll throw. I think it's okay to have this side out. So now put them back on. Kind of. Should be able to just kind of work it on here. There.
does help if you kind of lubricate it up too.
I should probably do that.
Got some Windex here. There we go. Able to spin that one in there. Kind of try and do the same thing on this side. Guys, there are easier ways of doing this. This is just the way I'm doing it right now and working with what I got to work with. This thing has absolutely kicked my ass tonight with everything that I've done. Let's put our cap back on here before we forget about it. And unless that wants to give me a problem too, which it probably will. There we go. We got that on there. I did get our new tire on. The rim inflated. Again, I need to get new wheel bearings for it, but I'll try and source them out tomorrow. If I can. So we already have our washer on there. Throw our tire on. Throw another washer on the outside. And our pin, our keeper, which for some reason seems very loose on there. I don't know why, because this is the one for down here. Let's try and tighten that up a little bit. Okay, got our keeper back on there. And again, guys, I mean, there's some play. Definitely need our wheel bearings done. That is moving 10 times better than it was, since before it wasn't moving at all. The other side feels like it might be hanging up a little bit. Just gonna add some grease to it quick, see if that helps. It was kind of rough to get grease in that nipple, but it did take that steering a lot better than it was. So I am happy with that. I'm going to take it for a test drive quick, just to make sure that it is steering how I want it to, and then I'll bring it back in the garage. It did feel a lot better now, but I do think that because we do have both new ones anyway, we might as well just replace them. That way, we know both are new. That way, if we're having issues anywhere, we know it's not in the spindles themselves. This one's not going to come off as easy as the other one. There we go. That off. Take our washer off. And we can take the wheel and slide that off. Set that off to the side. So now we got that. Let's take our cap off the top of this. Caps are always a pain. I hate them. I know. I get why they're there. I just hate having to take them off. I'm sure there's a million other ways that I could take these off. Good flathead. I can't find one. This one will work for us. Why not? There we go. Yeah, we got it. Good news is it does seem to spin more freely than the other side. It'd be better if this clip would come off though. There we go. And take our washer off. Let's get our tie rod off. And then hopefully we can just drop this thing out of here.
tie rod out of the way. And hopefully. Hopefully we can just work this thing out. Definitely coming easier than the other side did. I will say that. Not by much, but it is. Trying not to mushroom the side like we did the other. That is when we ended up having to grind it off. Apparently now is when it's going to start to be a pain for us. Alright, I'm going to try to get this out of here and I'll bring it back. And so, I got the other side done. That one was a pain in the ass as well. But we got the new spindle on there. We got the tire and everything back on. I took it for another test drive. It's a night and day difference. It's so much better now. So, my phone is about to die. And it's already like almost 9:30, if not already past 9:30 at night. So I think the last thing that we're going to do for tonight is we're going to get this oil drained out of here. That way tomorrow when we come back out, it's already going to be taken care of and we can add some new oil to it. If this cap wants to come off. Apparently, like everything else tonight, this wants to fight me as well. What else is new tonight? These are supposed to just pop right out. Unfortunately, last night when I was recording, my phone died while I was draining the oil out of this. But we did get all the oil out. We got the new oil filter put on as well. So now what we just gotta do, we just gotta add some fuel, add some oil to it. And I've got some just cheap Travelers SAE 30 that we're gonna put into it. The oil that came out of here was very dark and dirty, so it was definitely time for an oil change. We're just going to put this in here. Once we get our oil in, The other thing we'll need, I have a new air filter port that we'll put in. I do have new spark plugs for it as well. I don't know if we need them, but I have them, so we might as well just put them in. We got about 48 ounces in there right now. Just gonna check it. Now we got our two quarts of oil in there. We're sitting good now with our two quarts of oil in there. Now we got the oil in there. Let's get our air filter cover off. That air filter definitely needs to be replaced. Pre-filter here. Yeah, it seems like we have some nesting in here, so maybe we want to pull that cover off as well. But we do have our new air filter here. I think what I'm going to do, though, guys, I think I'm going to pull this top cover off quick. Just kind of make sure that we're clean underneath. And then we'll come back to putting the rest of this back on. As bad as I thought it was going to be when I pulled that cover. So now we'll go, we'll put our pre-filter in first. Then we will take our air filter and set that in there. Take our cover, put that back on. And we got that. Since I have new spark plugs, let's just change our plugs out. Fortunately, I don't know where my spark plug socket is right now, so I'm just going to use a regular 5/8 socket and just be careful with it. Burnt up, so might as well just replace them. Got new ones anyway. Side, put the other one on. Yeah, that one could definitely be replaced as well. We got new plugs on here. I think the last thing we're gonna do is I have a new fuel filter to throw on here. See if I can bring you guys in here more. Filter's pretty well shot, so we are gonna throw a new one on there.
go. That side off. I guess that side was being a little more ornery. Our new fuel filter on there. Get our clamps back on. Okay, got our clamps back on there, our fuel line back there, and we are all good on that now. There we have it. I think this is basically gonna finish off this mower. I do have a little bit of stuff that I still gotta do to it before it's ready to go for sale. I need to re-clock the steering wheel, I think. It's just, steering wheel's off a little bit. I just went through though and cut my big yard, and guys, it's a night and day difference for how the steering is now. So at least now we have new steering components on it. We have new air filter, fuel filter, spark plugs. I do have new blades to go on it as well. I'm not going to put new blades on it right this second though. I do think I want to try and straighten this deck out just a little bit more, just that way the new blades aren't getting chewed up. Other than that, I do need to get new wheel bearings. I tried looking this morning for some wheel bearings. I went to two different places. Nobody has them, so I'm just going to order them offline. I should have them in the next day or so. Get some new wheel bearings on it. Gonna get it cleaned up, and then this one will be ready to go for sale. So I appreciate you guys sticking around. If you want to drop a like, comment, subscribe, share the video, it means a lot, and I will see you guys in the next video. Thanks for watching.